Nuttyatonline.com/livewire.
We got Aaron and Ben. Good morning, my friends.
Morning, guys.
Morning.
Good morning.
This is one of my favorite times of the year, Scott. I think you'll agree. This is around the time that all of them summer brews start floating in into the bars. You start getting rid of the winter lagers and all that, and you start getting those light, fun, sometimes experimental beers. And you guys have a big one this year for the 75th anniversary of Old Bay Seasoning, mind you. Do you know that it's the 75th anniversary of the greatest spice on the planet?
I did not know that.
You did not know. Goes good on crabs or at a big fat rail. Clean up your nose. All right? Do not snort Old Bay. You will go to the ER. What is the what's the name of the new beer? What do you got?
The new beer is called Dead Rise Old Bay Summer Ale.
That's a sinister name for a beer.
Yeah, what is Dead Rise? Where do you get that?
So well, the name Dead Rise actually comes from a Chesapeake crabbing boat. So the line of the boat to navigate the waterways of the Chesapeake, it's actually a Dead Rise. But we do love that it's kind of sinister
see?
As well.
Oh, wow. Mm-hmm. It's got the tie-in. So it's a Dead Rise Summer Ale, and it has Old Bay in it. Explain that to me. What is that?
So we added Old Bay to the Whirlpool, which is the last stage of the hot side of brewing, and it adds some flavor and adds some aroma, and it sort of get, you know, we did about 12 pilots of it before we dialed it in, because it's a tricky spice to work with, but for beer, but I think our brewers nailed it. And
is this what I have here?
Is this because mm-hmm. you can't it. Just don't just take like your regular beer and like sprinkle a little bay in there, it ain't gonna work. You gotta brew the flavor. Sniff here.
We thought that, you know, it would be kind of bad if you couldn't taste the Old Bay, but we also thought that there was a balance where we didn't want it to be so overpowering. So I think our brewers really nailed it.
You've already taken a sip. I'm just kind of enjoying the bouquet. I get that light hint of Old Bay, because Old Bay is a seasoning that if you don't use it properly, it's going to take over whatever you put it on. All right, it's one of those seasons you use sparingly.
God, that's a damn good beer.
Let's get a sip on this. Dead Rise from Flying Dog. Yeah.
Speaks, you get any?
I
don't drink in the morning.
Hits the sides.
A lot of those.
Hits the sides of your tongue, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Let that hang out in your mouth for a second. Hits the sides of your tongue. Oh, yeah.
It tastes so good when it hits your lips, really.
Mm-hmm.
It does.
When it gets on there. And you got other flavors. What else you bring with you?
Yeah, what is that one over there? I like this one in front of...
I like the white label.
Yeah, the next one we have is an easy IPA.
White everything.
That's the new thing that people are doing now, because the IPAs are huge, obviously. Everybody likes the hop, but then when the summer comes around...
CrossFit Alex.
It's hard to drink a lot of those thick, hop-heavy beers. Everybody's, you know, now you got the lighter hoppy beers, the lighter IPA. It's good for the summer.
Yeah, absolutely. You don't want to have that kind of big ABV when it's 95 degrees and humid outside. So we want to have that same nice hop character that you used to, but
A
little lower ABV for you.
What are you thinking?
This is called the Easy IP. And first, and then the labeling, of course, stellar as always.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, Ralph Stedman, our label artist, has done. He does a great job. We ask him to draw specific things, and he draws whatever he wants.
How many people have that Flying Dog logo tatted on them? They have to. That makes for a killer tat.
We do get a lot of pictures sent to us with people inking themselves.
Greg Warren, you seem to be a gentleman. Are you not down for the spirits?
No, I'm with Josh on that.
Okay,
it looks great though, man. Yeah, it looks.
I love the color.
Smells great.
Here we go. Oh yeah, splash it on your neck. Use it like a cologne. Here we are. Oh, that's good. It's got beer in it.
You can taste the beer.
It's just this weather. You know what I mean? Like,
it makes me want to sit outside.
You get home and from work, and it's 75 degrees and sunny out, and it's these are perfect beers for that. Perfect.
Yeah, we call them lawnmower beers.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man.
I like that. Okay, there you go.
Lawnmower beers. I love that phrase. God, that's good. It makes me want to work in the garden. Get my hands in the earth. Get some brown on my fingers. What else you got?
Then they got another one.
We have a Bloodline Blood Orange Ale.
So real blood.
We came out with this one last year as a limited release, and it was a big hit. So we used blood orange puree. It's a pretty hop-forward beer. A little bit higher in ABV. Than
you say hop-forward?
Yeah. What's that mean? It's pretty hoppy.
Hoppy.
Even though it's not
hop-forward.
Technically an IPA.
Okay.
But it's 7%, so a little higher than
we've been
drinking.
Go ahead and get you some. Yeah. Now, I don't want to speak out of turn, and correct me if... Is this available on tap anywhere?
This is available right now. It's on tap at all the Buffalo Wild Wings across the state, and it'll be released for real in bottles and everything on June 1st.
Is it available in a children's style juice box?
So this has blood orange in it? Blood orange puree.
Oh, smell that.
Bloodline.
Smell that. Take a draw on that before you take a sip.
Ooh.
Oh! Woo!
Yeah.
God damn.
The orange
like
comes through.
Scott's parents' house in Florida.
Oh, I like that. I don't know what that meant, you son of a bitch.
They're near an orange grove. I'm getting very
drunk.
Nice.
I'm getting drunk today.
Let's get hammered and yell at Dave. Here we go.
Rainy day.
Oh, that is rough forever.
That is good. It's not that hop good. Forward. Not too killer on the
You
hop.
Can see through it. That's the thing. One of those super hoppy beers, you can't even shine a light through. I can't mess with that. I can still see all of your hideous faces through it. There we go. And that's
so
blood
we got
orange.
Dead Rise, Easy IPA, and Bloodline. You guys are killing it this summer.
I love the color on that blood orange. What's the last one you got for us?
Yeah, right. We have our
another one?
Another one.
Oh, yes. Dog is killing it right now.
It's called Lesbo Hair. It tastes like Mike.
There's going to be a lot. Look at me. And I'm not just saying this. There's going to be a lot of Flying Dog in my fridge this summer.
Hell yeah, there
Hell
is.
Yeah.
Not just for
are
the
fantastic.
Bottles. I haven't done it for the booze, but the bottles. It's just great when you crack open a fridge and you see that you've got all those Flying Dog logos. You're like, this is somebody that takes their beer seriously.
Well, here's the thing. Okay, you got all these the new craft beers. The movement is happening, obviously. And over by my house, we have the Lighthouse Liquors. They have a great selection. And you walk, I mean, that case they have, when you walk down and you look to the left, great case of craft beers. It goes for, you know, 10 yard, 15, 20 yards of just beers. And then you guys have your packaging. And, I mean... It just stands out.
You guys both got a great package.
It's a standout package.
Oh,
you see the great,
solid
beautiful
package.
Big package.
How you doing, Aaron?
And it's like, hey, what's that?
What is that?
Catches your eye.
It's colorful. Mm-hmm. All right, so to piggyback what Scott's saying, you got certain beer brands now. Have you seen no beer brands named, but the ones that they're doing the uber plain label, like you know, try new it brand from whatever famous beer maker.
Yeah,
it's
yeah,
like
yeah.
All blood red. Tiny little words, or all just silver. I like some color on my bottle, like something I want to put on a shelf somewhere when people come over. Like it's like a work of art on glass. What's this last one?
This is our Woody Creek. It's a Belgian style white beer.
Okay.
So gonna have like it's unfiltered. So
you
get
I was
a
gonna
nice
say
bowl.
Unfiltered. Okay.
All right. You know I love that it's white.
I know my beers.
Here we are. Good stuff. Oh, it tastes reliable.
Yeah,
oh, that's light.
That's a Belgian white for
oh,
you.
Oh, that is definitely a Belgian white. Oh, man, look at that. Look at that color.
Maybe drop a slice of fruit in there if you'd like, whatever kind you desire,
Stir
some sort of citrus
finger.
Fruit.
Oh, man, that's good. Oh, now this is a pint glass on a summer day. This one goes down easy.
This is your kind of beer. This is what you like. You like these kind.
Mm-hmm. I like them. I like them a lot. I like a light, fruity beer.
Because you have a vagina.
I have five vaginas.
I don't want to say anything.
No,
out of all the beers we've tasted, that is the most...
That's
feminine
good.
Of them, is it not?
It is feminine.
It sure is.
I order two, one to drink.
Ben,
and
would
the
you
one,
not agree with me?
Is splash
that,
on
out of
my
all the ones we've had, that would be the one that the chicks would go for, right?
I would agree.
And then where's this guy go? He
Either.
Goes for that one
immediately. My husband loves it.
This is my wife's favorite beer.
See,
it is. Yes,
you're such a woman.
I'm such a chick.
You're such a woman.
Oh, thank you again, Flying Dog Brewery. If you have a watering hole that you go to, and they don't stock any of these, what does a consumer say to their bartender or manager there?
It's everywhere.
About getting it in.
It's everywhere, but you know, the biggest collection, we have a festival coming up in Frederick on May 31st, and the Maryland Craft Beer Festival. It's the Brewers Association of Maryland. It'll be the most Maryland beers ever together, and we'll be there with 10 or 12 of our beers, and it's going to be a good time, downtown Frederick, so...
Now, Frederick, you know, is a little bit ways out there.
Yeah,
I live down in the city. Okay, I'm hiring some sort of limo door to door. How long is it taking me? Because I got to get out there and get drunk, but I don't want to be driving, so I'll get a party bus.
Limo, if you're taking a limo, I think they can get out there in about 45, 50
That's
minutes.
That's it?
Yeah.
It's not bad, dude.
It's not bad at all.
I'll go halvesies. I'll
actually,
gladly go halves with
hey,
you.
Hey, you load up with 10, 15 people in a party bus and you head out there?
And actually, for that particular event, we have buses that are running from Heavy Seas, Union, Brewing and Jailbreak Brewing in Laurel. So,
and I promise before we let you go, you
Heavy Seas and Union right here in the city. There's buses running.
Yep.
Oh
yeah.
My God!
Would you ever consider doing a small limited edition JSS small batch?
Yeah,
like just
morning show beer.
24 bottles. Us on the label. Aaron shaking her head. No, I'm going to turn to Ben. We help with the flavor profile. Yeah. We come up with the label limited. Edition yep. beer, throwing it back to the KML brew back in the day.
I can say we just had a 15-barrel pilot brewery installed within our brewery, so we are...
Yeah, that's perfect. That's all
think,
we need.
If you think coming out with four beers for the summer is on the edge, I think we're about to get even more experimental with our beers.
Well,
so.
Let's do it, and the thing is, there needs to be a little bit of us.
Yeah.
Us.
Hey, you see, hey.
In the beer.
We want some us in the beer.
If you get what I'm saying.
Yeah,
you
see
what
we're saying? Check with the FDA on,
yeah,
on how that.
Yeah, once you boil it, it all gets sterile, right?
What's the big deal? We're going to cry into the bottles. That's all it is.
It's Justin Scott and Spiegel, the 98 Rock Morning Show. 98online.com.